And the Levites, the sons of Asaph, with what cymbals to praise the Lord after the what? Ordinance of the of David, king of Israel. Now the Levites, now just think, for example, you have we had a choir today, and their requirements is just to, the only criteria is that can you sing? Can you carry a note? Because I wouldn't make the choir. I'll be a bench player, second team player, so I can't carry a note. But I wouldn't be a good choir member, but you got somebody like Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston. She can carry a note. Which one of us would be more qualified for Moses' choir? Which one is more qualified? Anybody here but me?
Well, if the only criteria was voice, if that was the only criteria, then Whitney. But I submit to you that
she ready for
choir,
was she not ready for ministry.
If that was the only criteria, yes. But otherwise,
playing the piano, instruments. Let's see here. Elton John.
No.
Is he ready for ministry? Set him up in the temple. He can really get that thing going. Williams don't know the scale. Big bang, and I get something. But I would be more qualified. Because as a Levite, I at least know what? The word. And I could minister to somebody. Back in that day, Levites was strictly to, Levite priesthood strictly minister, was to minister, nothing else. Able to minister. And as you see now, churches these days, that is not the criteria. You get anybody to get that's got the skills, the talent, the musical, the orator, all that, and that's the one. Maybe that's the one. But then, back in that day, you had to be shown up qualified and from birth on able to be a minister. That was your job as a Levite. Okay, so their job was to, and the Levites, the sons of Asaph, with cymbals to praise the Lord after the ordinance of David the king. And some of the, what they sing, look at Psalms 80. When they gathered together, it was such an, it was like a big orchestra, if you ask me. There were so many of them. When you see the chief musician, everybody ever read that when you read the Psalms? You wonder, who's this chief musician? The chief musician, the choir director. This is what he did. And it's got all of this noise and splendor. And they sung when he gave the cue. Give ear, O shepherds of Israel, thou that leadest Joseph like a flock, thou that dwellest between the cherubims, shine forth. This is a song. Verse 3, what do you say? Turn us again, O Lord, and cause thy face to shine, and we should be what? Saved. And Lord God of hosts, how long will I be angry against the prayer of thy people? So this is, they're interceding, they're intercessors, they're doing all of this kind of stuff. Now, look at Psalms 81. Let's look at that there. There again, the choir director. And again. He says, sing aloud unto God, make a joyful noise unto the God of Jacob. That's what they're doing. They're ordained to sing. Take a song, bring hither the tremble, pleasant harp, psaltery. Blow up the trumpet in the new moon, the time appointed on our solemn feast day. So they do, this is what they did. They kept worship going. That's their job. And you couldn't be, you had to be clean, you had to be pure, you had to be holy. You had to know what you were doing. Now, let me see here. Let's look at numbers 1 through 50.
Numbers.
This is the prescribed way. Is that Numbers is part of the first five books of the what?
Bible.
Numbers 1 and 50.
1 and 50.
1 and 50. Work of the Levites. Tell me what it says.
But thou shalt appoint the Levites over the tabernacle mm-hmm. of testimony mm-hmm. and over all vessels thereof mm-hmm. and over all things that belong to it.
Yeah.
They shall bear the tabernacle and all the vessels thereof, and they shall minister unto it and shall encamp round about the tabernacle.
Okay, and so everything about the tabernacle, the house of the Lord is to be handled by the ministers. Verse 51.
And when the tabernacle setteth forward, mm-hmm. the Levites shall take it down. Mm-hmm. And when the tabernacle is to be pitched, mm-hmm. the Levites shall set it up.
Yeah.
And the stranger that cometh nigh shall Ooh. Be put to death.
This ain't your job. This is the law of the land, and you got no business up here messing around. What you think you are? The only answer for you right now is what?
Death.
You don't mess with the stuff of God if you're not appointed. Anybody ever seen any preachers that wonder if they were appointed?
Yeah.
Keep that to yourself. Numbers, third chapter, verse 5. Someone read 5 through 9 if you would.
And the Lord, 3 and 5?
Five through 9.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying,
yeah.
Bring the tribe of Levi near,
yeah.
and present them before Aaron the priest, that they may minister unto him.
Yeah.
And they shall keep his charge,
yeah.
and the charge of the whole congregation before mm. the tabernacle of the congregation
yeah.
to do the service of the tabernacle.
Yeah.
And they shall keep all the instruments of the tabernacle of the congregation
mm.
and the charge of the children of Israel
yeah.
to do the service of the tabernacle.
Yeah.
And thou shalt give the Levites unto Aaron and to his sons. And excuse me, they are wholly given unto him out of the children of Israel.
Everyone know about the history of the Levites. The Levite tribes and the priests come from the children of Aaron. And Aaron, those he gave them for nothing but for ministry. The kids are raised but for ministry. Now that we're coming out of captivity, the best we can find of the leftover of this bunch, they back in Aaron's day, they had to be 30 years plus. The best we can find now is 20. Gotta go. Ain't that big. Gotta go to 20. Now, would you say this is a great beginning or kind of rough beginning? A start, restart. We going good? We got it going on? How many would be confident we can get this thing done?
It was a little challenge.
A little challenge. You got Junior over here that ain't read nothing. He don't know nothing. He don't even know how to lay in. He don't know how to open up the wall. Bottle wall. We got just a few. All we got, we ain't got no what.
And not only that, they got all kind of opposition around.
Huh?
Not only that, but they got all kind of
opposition around.
They want that temple rebuilt.
Sometimes when the Lord tells you to do something and get it done, you don't come out of the gate with everything, tangible that you need to get this done. Sometimes your vision is a whole lot larger than your what? Pocketbook, resources, personnel, and everything else. Wow, just not there. But God says, you feel it? We got to get back to where we were. He says, do it. Now, the best we got right now is that we got the foundation. So I guess when you say lay the foundation, everybody is happy because we got the foundation laid. Okay, let's go on there. That was back in verse 10. They're ready to have church. Let's go, if you, in our Bible, we have Ezra, we're in the third chapter, but look at the second chapter, verse 40 and 42. See if we can get an idea of how many of them actually came back. Ezra is right after 2 Chronicles. Verse 2, I mean chapter 2, verse 4. How many?
What verse? I mean,
verse 40. Yeah, how many you say, brother? 74. We used to have more priests than that alone. We used to have more priests than that. Now we just got the Levites, the children of Jeshua, the children of Hodiah, 74. How many singers that we were reading about in Psalms 80? 128. If we got a choir that big, we got a choir going on. We'll be ready to go on TV and everything else. We think we're in the big leagues. All you got, 74 preachers and 128 singers. Okay, I just want to kind of give you a picture of that. That was okay. So we're going to chapter 3. Okay, chapter 3, verse 11. Someone read that if you will, please.
And they sang together by course in praising and giving thanks unto the Lord, mm-hmm. because he is good, mm-hmm. for his mercy endureth forever toward Israel.
Was that true or not true? Just in the sinner. Is his mercy really always toward Israel?
True.
Yes. Yes. Mm-hmm. But sometimes you got to drum it in to them young bucks. 20-year-old preachers, let me tell you, somebody in that crowd that came back had to really shake them up and tell you, the Lord is, this is a good thing. This is a good thing that we're coming back to rebuild the temple. Even though you're looking at stuff and it don't look like this is a good thing that you're coming back into prayer. This is a good thing. All right, finish up, please.
And all the people shouted with a great shout when they praised the Lord.
Yeah.
Because the foundation of the house of the Lord was laid.
Because the foundation of the house was laid. From the start of this lesson to this verse right here, do you think there was ever any discouragement that they charged her to
heal? It was discouragement. Oh, yeah.
Think there was some discouragement?
Absolutely.
What is the business of the prophet? It's supposed to be like that Scotch and preacher.
I'm just asking. You
screen them out there.
Oh, yes.
Well, what is the business of the prophet?
Give God's word. Tell them what God said.
How do you know, other than the coming to pass, what he said is supposed to come to pass, how do you know that you have been in the presence or you've heard from a true prophet? Because Ephesians 4:11, God has given to the church.
Prophet.
So how do you know when you have heard, are you in the presence of a prophet? You've heard and you know that you've been in the presence of a prophet. I'll sit down. Somebody say it to me. They might know.
It should validate the word of God.
So
it should validate the word.
It should validate the word.
Right.
Somebody else, help me out.
Followed by some type of demonstration.
So what do you have in mind?
A prophet is to
encourage.
Am I right? to encourage you. It don't look too good right now. What does Isaiah, when you read Isaiah, say? The day will come, the day will come. You'll see, and you'll know. You will know for sure.
Do prophets always encourage?
He always. Now, does he always?
No, he doesn't. Okay. Remember, Jeremiah, I was going to say Elijah. Elijah. Oh, we open a can of worms. Let's not go there.
I'm getting my bullets together. I'm getting into the word right
now. Okay, now, I'm going to close it up then.
I'm getting my bullets together. Here we go. Zachariah.
That's one function, but it's not always.
Isaiah, he says, behold, I'm going to show you something new. You're going to like it. Stuff looks bad right now. A virgin shall conceive. What? Are you crazy, Isaiah? A virgin shall conceive and brings forth a son. You should call his name. And everybody else is in captivity feeling down. He says, no, it's going to get better. How much better? A whole lot better. A whole lot better. Then you guys, gotta go build this temple, do it again. We got no money. We really ain't got no preachers. Ain't got no choir. What are we gonna do? So here's what Zechariah and Haggai said something too. These are contemporaries back of that day. Zechariah 4, right? 6 through 10. This is what Zechariah says. Anybody got it? Looking bad. No tangible encouragement.
Then so he answered,
Go ahead.
And spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying, not by might nor by power, but by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts.
Not by power, nor by my spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. The prophet Paul says that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. He says, how are we going to get it done? Wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against spiritual wickedness and stuff. So he says, this is where you gotta go. You gotta look inside. You gotta look in your spirit. You can't look at the things that someone else says. He that observeth the wind forsake his own way. Looking at this stuff, lying vanities, he that observe lying vanities forsake his own mercy. And then the prophet comes one year out and says, this is what the Lord told me. My fellow people. Not by power, not by mind, but my spirit. So he had to encourage them. Haggai said something in the second chapter. She's a small prophet back at the end of the Bible. So she said, just before the book of Zechariah. She's so small, she only had two chapters. Such a minor prophet. And we've heard this guy, Zerubbabel, right? Remember we've read his name a little while ago? Second chapter 1-9 actually, but see what says any encouragement in there. These are Old Testament prophets. The son of Shedetel, governor of Judah, to Joshua, the son of Joshedech, that's the guy we've been reading about, spelled different, the high priest, to the residue of the people, saying, who is left among you that saw this house in her what? And how did you see it what? Even though you see it now, he says, be what in verse 4?
Now be strong.
Be strong. Work of a prophet. And O Zerubbabel said the Lord, be what? And Joshua, son of Joiada, the high priest, said, do what?
Be
strong. All you people of the land, said the Lord, and work, for I am with you, said the Lord of what? Hosts. It don't look good, but I got me a prophet, and he's going to come through and do what? Encourage. Oh, you ain't got no money, barely got some preachers, ain't got no choir. Trying to have church, be what? Strong. Keep going, keep going, keep going. This is another prophet, said another one that by the other day and said that it's not by power nor by might, but by my spirit. Another prophet come along, a little bit old, somebody named Haggai, called a minor prophet, and had a whole bunch of different writings. She only had two chapters in the whole book of the Bible. So the Lord says, well, be encouraged. Verse 5, according to the word that I did what with you? When I did what? Coming out of word?
I promised you.
I promised you in my covenant when I brought you out of Egypt that I was going to do some stuff for you. I'm just going to do it. Whoa. But I'm going to observe these lying vanities, and if I observe these lying vanities, that's going to negate the prophet of the Lord. So you got to stay encouraged, no matter what it looks like. Oh, boy. Verse 8, what did he say?
Silver is mine, and gold is mine, said the Lord of hosts.
We ain't got none, but God said he got plenty of it. All right? The glory of this latter house is going to be what? Said the Lord of hosts. And in this place will I give peace, said the Lord of hosts. It don't look good on the natural, but he sent a prophet by to say, be encouraged. What is the office of a prophet to do? Encourage you. He might show you what you've been sitting. But that ain't his primary job. His primary job is to encourage you to keep going in the Lord. Strike up the music. That's it. We ain't got to do this. Encouragement. 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 I got to go forward. I got to go forward. I got to do the work of the Lord. God says, I got somebody. He'll be by tomorrow. He's going to encourage you. You're going to face Monday. Monday's going to be Monday. Tuesday's going to be Tuesday. But God says, according to my word, like I promise, it's going to happen in your life. Okay. Yeah, let's keep on going. Back to our lesson. Verse 11, I'm going to read it again. And they sang together by chorus in praising and giving thanks unto the Lord. Look at this. They got the choir somewhat together. Together by chorus. I don't know. Anybody ever sing in a choir before? Anybody got any idea what that is? The altos, the sopranos. Those that do, your turn, your turn, your turn. They got him a little bit of a choir going because he is good. Can you imagine him singing that? And wonder if they're quiet, low-key, making a high, big noise. What kind of noise they're making? They're singing. They got that choir so good together by now that people from around is hearing that choir sing. What are they singing about? What are they so happy about? They all they got is a foundation. Well, verse 12. All right, so I turn to Psalms 118. Someone read verse 12.
But many of the prophets and Levites and chiefs of the fathers who were ancient men.
You mean they were what kind of men? Oh, the old dogs.
That had seen the first house.
Uh-oh.
When the foundation of this house was laid before their eyes, wept with a loud voice.
Yeah.
And many shouted aloud for joy.
This is what I call two different sounds, two different outlooks. One bunch cried aloud because they saw the way it used to be. One bunch shouted aloud because they saw the way that it's going to be. And many shouted. So there were those. They had seen the first house laid before their eyes. They wept with a loud voice. And then there was a whole bunch of them shouting with another voice for another reason. All right. So that the people could not, so we got crying. This is the way that it used to be. Oh, it was so great, so great, so great. And then there's those that saying, this is the way that it's going. How many ever been in a congregation where you had split opinion? Mm-hmm. They call that a split church. How many ever seen something just split? Just... And you have those that says that we used to do it this way, it used to be like that, and this and that, and all that and that. Then you got this other bunch that says, we see it the way that it's going to be, and then you got two different opinions. But here you see in the Bible that they shouted for two different reasons.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Uh-oh. Can the two often coexist together? Coexist peacefully. I'm going to add that as it.
Well,
this time it did.
This time it did.
Yep.
This time it did. This time it did. You think the old hands ever came up to speed this bunch? Because they always wanted to compare it to, that ain't as good as we used to be.
I think it's kind of like the Democrats and Republicans of the day. Sort of, kind of.
I think possibly the effects of slavery.
Mm-hmm.
As I said, the captor's objection was to change your mindset, mm-hmm. and tear down the faith.
Mm-hmm.
So the old dogs was seeing it from the past and crying because they couldn't see it getting any better.
Has everything ever matched the building that David put up?
No. Not even since then.
That has not been matched. And they were saying that even though we're here and the guy gave us,
this is what we lost.
You know what?
That's good.
How do we know that God said do this? I'm an old dog. How do we know that God said do this? We don't know. Who said do this? Cyrus, a Gentile. He's given us the permission to come build something for our God. Now compare that to David and Solomon, who said from the heart, we're going to build something for our God. And that was where it was, right? Oh, how free are we? We're still slaves. It's the old dogs. We're still slaves. We're not doing this from our strength. If we couldn't even get a shipment in, King had to give him the pass through. It's best to do something as a free people, free of sin, free of any other dictates, only by the strength of your faith and of the Lord, than to have somebody else dictate to you. And that's what was happening here. How do we really get free? Because if Cyrus is telling us we could do this, as far as they knew, it took a deep spiritual person like the prophets to say, no, take this opportunity, this is of the Lord. Mm-hmm. And then somebody says, do not despise, what kind of beginnings?
Small.
Don't despise those small beginnings, because you got to start somewhere. You got your opposition, you got the people even around you that's talking against you, and you got people in the camp that ain't much on board. Whoa.
The prophets were saying the latter glory is going to be greater than the former glory, and the old dogs were saying, I think he might have missed it, because this ain't nothing like
this. The Lord, the first time we did it, David and Solomon, you know they had the heartbeat of the Lord. King Cyrus says do it, and the only reason why we're protected is because King Cyrus. But then you got to have those that's in faith, like the prophets that come around and say, do it.
All the Gentiles all around them were laughing at them, making fun of them.
That
was trying to stop them.
So
but then they see the foundation laid.
And
that's when they started to
run. So if you're moving in faith against all the opposition, even the Lord will move in there. Mm-hmm. There's an opportunity for the Lord to move. But if you get somebody, call himself a prophet, and all he's going to come preach to you is that you shouldn't have sinned, that's why you're in captivity, I'm from Sky Took, and I preach like this, I preach to people, and I tell them this, and I tell them
that. Take that, delete that.
That's the other preacher we got to. And this is how we do it. We point them out. But when you get someone that says, go for it. Go forward in God. Go forward in God. That's the business of a prophet. Different from the business of a priest. A priest is actually hands-on doing the work. Ministering, singing, playing instruments. That's the minister. And sometimes churches fall this day and age. Well, the Bible gives us the prescription of how to build a church, how to have a church. But there's a lot of churches that just got talent. She got talent. We need a voice. And then later on down the line, that was really not the ministry. That was just talent. How many have been seeing this? I know I only call it commercials. Gospel sing-off type thing. Yes?
Sunday Best or whatever it was.
Oh, that Sunday Best.
Yeah, that commercial for that. I think it's what he's talking about.
Oh.
Yeah. They can sing. No. They sing all of the songs. Mm-hmm. Crooning, a cappella, something like that. Is that ministry? Yeah. People turn into that and say, oh, that's, oh, yeah, I feel the spirit, right? This service is brought to you by Northside Christmas Center.
Not scattered.